So this is the cockpit, and they replaced all the teak deck, not inside the cockpit, but all in the decking area. And they just put Sika Flex, that's the black lining, and it has to dry for 15 days. And after that, they're gonna take it off and they start sanding. Put the pressure on it because the boat has to go out, because in September, the wintering boats are coming in.
The railing, we just did a part that were damaged.
Yeah.
But they're gonna sand everything.
The tow rail, you mean?
The tow rail, yeah. And they're gonna sand everything, so everything will be the same color.
We left Amsterdam and drove to our sailing home in Turkey,
where we saw the perfect scent for the first time after 8 months.
We are refitting her now. She's in a hangar without keel and mast and in need of a new teak deck, hull color, lithium batteries, instruments and sails.
So we finally can call her home and start sailing the world.
Good morning. Today we're gonna check the rigging. Have a look if we have to change the rigging, because probably the rigging is the original rigging, so it's 16 years old. It's a big job to change the rigging, and an expensive job to change the rigging. But safety first helps the mast getting straight up, and when there is a failure and the mast comes down, then we have a big problem, and especially on the middle of the ocean. And we met somebody who has a similar boat. His mast came down not because of a failure in the rigging, but because of an accident. And it was quite impressive. We have a meeting with the owner of Yachtworks. His name is Chan. He is sailing around the world himself. He's sailing in a Halberg LC 38. Yeah, he's a very experienced sailor, well-known naval architect, and with a lot of knowledge. So I can learn a lot from him. So at the moment we are taking out the diesel from the spare tank. It was there for probably 10 years. It was very dirty, so we are getting it out. The shaft is back in. There's a new bearing, and now we're gonna go inside and put the stopper on it, but it looks beautiful. So now the deck is has to dry. We can work inside the boat, and we're gonna finally get the pole at the back off, because the pole is there, maybe because of a wind generator or over there, so we're gonna take it down. Thank you, Rihanna, for pushing the envelope to get the pole up. So the Finslate project is happening. We put all the Finslate over here. It's like a carpet, because we're gonna put the Finslate before the final wrapping of the hull. We're gonna leave one top layer. We leave it open and we're gonna do it afterwards. So what they are doing right now is to measure the hull size. And after that, we're gonna start with the first layer. This is Rick. He is the inventor of Finslate. He came yesterday to Turkey and to apply it on the boat. This is the first time they're gonna apply it on an existing copper coat.
So we've done the preparation works with the strip for the water line, so we can make sure that there's no seams on the water line. And now we're gonna start doing the applications. First the water line and keel. And then afterwards we do the big sheets in between. So that's why it's important not to have a seam like this. But if you apply it like this, then the waves are not hitting it so badly. So that's why I always start with the one here on the keel. Then afterwards you you apply the ones on the waterline next to it.
Also put Finslate in the boat thruster. We're gonna use, instead of the C grade, what is here on the hull, We're gonna use speed grade. It's 1 millimeter thin, so we can apply it here in the bow thruster tunnel. So that's the solution for that. So you don't need another kind of anti-fouling to put in to get the same result.
This is, in my opinion, the best product in the market at the moment. It's called Finzolate. It's a completely different system. It's not a paint, it's a wrap. So what you do normally nowadays with above the water parts, for example, you can put a wrap. This is a wrap for underwater. It's a self-adhesive material, and it works on the basis of fiber. So you can see you remove the backing paper and then it's really just like a sticker.
Thank you very much. We're going to show you all the waters where we are sailing in. And
I hope you enjoy it.
We will. Thank you. So they are preparing the hull, so they are sanding it and polishing it so the wrap can be on. The boat is getting in shape again. So look at this. So now we're gonna prepare your bike, isn't it, bike? Preparing the rail to get it up because the boat got wrapped in the coming days. So preparing the whole hull, and they can put the whole wrap around it so it looks pretty nice. So the whole hull is getting wrapped, even under the waterline as above the waterline, and I think that's pretty amazing. Here we have a big pole. This is the pole, and it was always a pain in our eyes to look at it. So we decided to get rid of it, and we're gonna make a bowsprit out of it. So we're gonna cut it here and here, thanks to one of our followers and patrons and owner of the same type of boat we have. He showed us how we can make a bowsprit out of it. All coming to an end. So wrapping the hull, sanding the teak deck, then all the bits and pieces inside, because we have to varnish a lot of the wood inside. And then in 3 weeks hopefully we are in the water again. So this is really fantastic. This is the beauty of a full refit boatyard. They do everything by themselves. You don't have to shop for anything. All the expertise they have themselves. So for example, our cover, it was full with scratches. He took out all the butt scratches. And it's like new. And I asked him to replace this one, and he's gonna make it right now. So this is the master. So we met these guys on the boatyard, and they built this boat all by themselves. It's a design, it's a Tanton 40.
Bristol Channel
cutter.
In England.
In England.
Yeah.
Yeah, you built it all by yourself.
Yeah, yourself.
Yeah. For 2 years.
Two years of building.
2 years. And where are you gonna sail? Here in the Mediterranean?
Yeah.
So today they're gonna wrap the boat, so it's kind of a big day. The guys already came, and this is the foley. So this is gonna be the color. And So just before Benjamin goes to bed, we're gonna have a look. They're gonna work tonight here in the boatyard for the wrapping on the hull. It'll be getting fantastic. Okay guys, I'm here at Berkey Records and it's a funny story. We got invited by Business News Radio in the Netherlands to record a commercial and they're gonna publish it on the radio. But how to record it? So yesterday I tried to record in the engine room of the Perfect Sense, but it quality wasn't good enough. So I asked Chan to look out for a studio here in Didim and he found a really cool place. His name is not Berkey, but he just Berkey, and he just launched his own hip-hop video.
Come on.
He's gonna help us out, so we are really happy.
Our beautiful boat to see how the wrap is doing.
Yeah. Engine is not working.
Why not?
It's not starting.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now?
I think it's the starting engine again. So I have to look. Time to get some baklava for the guys on the boatyard because I believe they deserve it. Hey, Tay. Good morning!
Good
night, Dan! Good
morning!
How are you doing,
Buck?
And?
Beautiful!
And as you can see, we have a new color on the boat.
New color on the boat, and we've got a new wrap and anti-fouling on the lower boat.
A lot of things happen.
Yeah!
Benjamin is very happy. So we took off all the grown parts. I'm polishing it right now. But the guys, they are just putting the wrap on it and water line. So we've got here the Finsulate, then last layer of primer, but we're gonna put extra layer on Finsulate on top of the water line. So it's really tight. And here they are doing the water line. So that's gonna be bigger here. They heat it up like this, and then they kind of cut it. As you can see, they covered here the whole back already. How it will go, I'm really satisfied with the result at the moment, because this is, it's shiny, it covers the whole boat, new color, so you have a lot of flexibility, but we prefer the classic gray, so a dark blue hull. And we decided for a gray one line, one gray line. So very interesting to see the whole process from nearby. Isn't she lovely? getting so beautiful. Man. Isn't she lovely? Good morning. Today is the first day of the last episode of the teak deck. We're gonna start with sanding the teak deck. I watched while sanding the teak deck and I really got emotional. It's getting so beautiful, and all the hard work of these guys and the positive energy, and they are shouting all day long. Perfect sense, Captain, perfect sense. And today we're gonna do the final preparations of some Sika Flex.